third is refusing to answer questions. So here the two journalists, means in that there is a first case. Two journalists are sent to prison. The case was of an intense public interest. Two journalists refused to answer questions asked of them in a witness box. They were sent in prison where they were guilty of a contempt of a court or not. So here Lord Radcliffe, first the newspapers had been saying that was a spy in Admiralty, means newspaper has posted something like that, that in the Admiralty there was a spy and the parliament ordered for inquiry. Lord Radcliffe presided over it. One of the journalists had written that it was a sponsorship of two high-ranking officials which led to Vassal avoiding the according to the strictness part of the Admiralty security waiting. Waiting means examine. Lord Radcliffe asked the journalist, what was the source of your information? Where did you get it from? The journalist said, I declined to answer. So the journalists were imprisoned because they had posted something, and when they were asked to give the answer, that time they refused because Lord Radcliffe asked, will you inquire from the source whether he is willingly for it to be divulged? Then Lord Radcliffe punished them for the contempt of the court. Mr. Justice Gorman sentenced 6 months imprisonment for them. So here a point is that the preliminary point arose as to the relevancy of the question. A witness is only bound to answer a relevant question and not an irrelevant one. I dealt with the point in this way. Was the question relevant to the inquiry? So relevant question is asked, then answer is necessary to give. If the reported news is based on any trustworthy source, then the tribunal must see it. Otherwise, it's impossible to investigate. Means here the reporters should give the answer on what source they have posted such news. And the next B point is about the privilege, that a journalist has a privilege by law entitling him to refuse to give his sources for information. The journalist puts forward as his justification the pursuit of truth. It is in the public interest, he says, that he should obtain information in confidence and publish it to the world at large. For by so doing, he brings to the public notice that which they should know. He cannot get this information, he says, unless he keeps his source of it secret. The mouth of his informants will be closed to him if it is known that their identity will be disclosed. Means he has also the point that he cannot tell from whom source he has posted this. The only profession that I know which is giving a privilege from disclosing information to a court of a law is a legal profession, and then it is not the privilege of a lawyer but of his client. Take the clergyman, the banker or the medical man. None of this is entitled to refuse the answer when directed by a judge. Let me not be mistaken. The judge will respect the confidences which each member of these honorable professions receives in the course of it, and will direct him to answer unless. Unless not only it is relevant but also it is proper and indeed. Means here the judge is asking the question, from which source you have taken, then it's necessary for the journalist to tell the truth. A judge is a person who is entrusted on behalf of the community to weigh this conflicting interest. If the judge determines that the journalist must answer, then no privilege will avail him to refuse. And if the journalist have not answered, then how is anyone to know that this story was not a pure invention? If the journalist will not tell the tribunal its sources, even it was not an invention, how is anyone to know it was not a gossip of some idler seeking to impress? It may be mere a rumor, unless if the journalist